lot of you guys who don't know who I am, my name is Jordan Burroughs. These are my two little ones. They're going to be maneuvering and navigating around the room all day. So if you get an opportunity to say hello, this is Deacon. Deacon is 4 years old, and this is Aura, a little girl. She's 2 years old. So if you guys want to come up, say hello, grab a photo, just introduce yourselves to my little ones. That would be great. They're beautiful people. And so they enjoy saying hello to you guys as well. So I introduce myself. I'm originally from Sicklerville, New Jersey. And so relatively small town, went to a public school, no history, no tradition at my high school. I grew up about 20 miles outside of Philadelphia. And so if you want to get a reference point for where I grew up, I was right outside the city of Philly. It was a suburban area. And so I started wrestling when I was 5 years old. And like there was like no profound moment. It wasn't like in my lineage or my family history. I just got a flyer from my elementary school one day and said, join the local youth wrestling program. Right? So I brought it home and I showed my mom. I was 6 years old at the time. I showed my mom. I was like, hey, listen, I don't know what wrestling really is, but I got this flyer. It looks really cool. If it looks anything like I see on TV, right? Monday Night Raw, Thursday Night SmackDown, this is going to be sick. Like, I can't wait. Let's go. And so we went over to the local gymnasium at our high school in my town. It's Winslow Township High School. We went over, got there, and I saw a wrestling match laid out on the cafeteria floor like this. And I was like, well, this is not what I expected. I thought it was going to be like a legitimate wrestling match. I'm like, where are the tight ropes? Where are the guys who slam through tables? Like, where's the guys with the paint on their faces? Like, Ultimate Warrior's a little different than what I expected. But I stuck with it right away because I was the smallest guy in my family. I was the youngest of four. I was really tiny growing up. And so one of the few sports that you didn't have to be particularly big in or be a great athlete to be successful, right? Look at me now and the muscles that I have and the athletic prowess that I have, I didn't always look like this. I was really small growing up. My first weight class was actually 45 pounds. And so fast forward a few years, I got to high school. I was a 103-pounder as a freshman in high school. Didn't place in the state, didn't even make it to the state tournament. Fast forward my sophomore year, finally make it to the state tournament, didn't place, lost in the place in Ryan, so I got benched in the round of 12, my sophomore year of high school. Then go on to my junior year of high school, I finally broke through place in the state. I was actually state runner-up. I lost in the state finals to a guy named Frank Molinaro. Anyone ever heard of Frank Molinaro? Yep, so we grew up together in New Jersey. We actually wrestled each other in the state finals my junior year. So fast forward, again, my senior year, I finally win a state title. I break through, win a state title as a senior. And then I started getting calls from a few colleges in the area to have me come out and be a part of their program. So I didn't start getting calls or any sort of recruitment until after my senior year of high school. So like for me, when I look at you guys and I see some of the guys in the landscape now of recruiting, guys trying to figure out how to get to college, what the next step is, how to stay motivated, I think about where I was as a high school student. And for a long time, I didn't even know I was gonna wrestle at the next level. Right, when my high school coach sat me down and he was like, hey, what do you wanna do with your life? What do you wanna do next after high school? And I was like, I don't know. Generic answer at the time was I would wrestle in college. And so that was my answer. I said, I wanna wrestle at the next level. And he was like, I don't believe that. Your work ethic, the things that you're doing, your grades, they don't align with what you just told me. There's no way that you could want to wrestle at a Division I university and train the way you train. There's no way that you could want to wrestle at the highest level that this sport has to offer and have the grades that you have. It's just not possible. So I remember at that point, I really just tried to start making the transition to prepare myself for the next level. And the great thing about it for me was I had teammates that were already living lives of excellence. And so I just followed those guys. I followed the guys around me. I was like, what are you doing to get better? He was like, listen, I don't just train during the season. I train through summer. I was like, I'm going to follow you. I'm going to practice through summer. I was like, what about your weight? Like, what are you eating? He was like, well, these are the things that I put into my body. This is my nutritional plan. This is my diet. This is how I stay lean in order to make weight so I don't just have to starve myself. Right? Because I was one of those guys when I was in high school. I was like, listen, the less I eat, the less I have to work out. This is perfect. I don't have to do anything. I'm in sauna. I don't have to run. I don't have to wear a sweatsuit. I just don't eat, and I make weight. But as you get older, you realize that that's not the best method for competing at your highest level. And so I finally got recruited. Anyone went to college? Yeah, University of Nebraska. So I finally got recruited to go to the University of Nebraska. I decided to go there. Still took some bumps and bruises as a freshman. I was 16 to 13 my freshman year of college. I remember sitting down like, damn, is this for me? Like, do I really have what it takes to wrestle at this level? I didn't know. Because once I got to college, every single guy on the team was the best guy from their town. I'll never forget, my freshman year, we were going through a freshman orientation. So that's when all the athletes from all over the country that have become Huskers, they meet up with each other, and we have like this big event, huge meeting, everyone meets each other. Like, hey, where are you from? I'm from Singleville, New Jersey. Hey, where are you from? I'm from Deerfield, Illinois. And so I'm introducing myself with everyone around me, and I've got guys on my team from all parts of the country, all walks of life, all cultures, economic backgrounds, and I'm introducing myself because I just want to see change. And I remember it was so cool, and I had that jacket on at that freshman orientation, and I got there, and I was introducing myself to all my teammates, and I realized that having one state championship was the least of any of the freshmen. Right? We had one guy on the team, he was a four-time state champion, never even lost a match in high school.
Jesus.
Everyone was the best guy on their team, in their county, in their club, in their state, region of the country. So I remember I went back to my dorm room, I took off my jacket, I folded it up, I put it in the box, and I never wore it again. I haven't seen it since 2006. Right? And so I say all that to say this, guys. Like, I come from a place where there's not a ton of tradition, not a ton of lineage. We didn't have guys going to Division I universities and getting full scholarships and doing all this really cool stuff at the highest level. I didn't know what it was like. I watched the Olympics growing up, but I didn't know I could be an Olympian. Like, I hear a lot of Olympians, like, I knew from the time I was 5 years old I was going to be an Olympic gold medalist. That was always my dream. And for me, that's not true. I didn't realize I could make the Olympic team. And so I realized I could make the Olympic team. And so everyone's journey and path is going to be different. But the cool thing about it is I was in your position 12 years ago. I was sitting on the other end. And I was thinking, man, how am I going to get through this grind and get to the next level? What am I going to do? I'm going to separate myself from my opponents, from my teammates. How am I going to make myself known? Really cement my legacy as an athlete, as a person, and be greater than my parents were. How can I do that? And I went through this grind, right? So I never forget what it's like to be in a fire. I know it's difficult, right? It's Sunday morning. You guys would rather be at home playing Fortnite. Right, eating the leftover pizza from last night, getting ready for football this afternoon. I know, I understand that, but I also understand that the fact that you guys are here tells me that you guys want to get better. So I don't know how you got here, right? Some of you guys, your coach probably forced you to come. Let's be realistic. Other guys, your parents probably forced you to come. Some of you are just internally motivated. You wanted to be here because you wanted to get better. And so I'm going to do my best to teach you as much as I can in the small amount of time that we have together, but I want you guys to reciprocate that type of love and that type of energy. And so I want you guys to understand that if we're going to be here, then let's be fully you, right? Because regardless of what you want out of today, the fact is that you're going to be here for the next 2.5 hours anyway, right? So you can either waste it, squander it, and go into your season not feeling good about what you're able to do today, or you can dig down for the next 2.5 hours, learn some things, apply it to your wrestling, get better, and go forward throughout the rest of the season. Feeling like, damn, I learned some things right before the break of the new season, because I believe you guys start this Monday, right?
Tomorrow.
Damn, it's here. It's here. So, this is not even like off-season training anymore. This is like the first day of practice. This is the first day of official practice. And for all you guys that finished up last season, not where you want to, we have any state champs here? Right, so we all have something to work on. I imagine that every one of you guys' season last year finished up with either a loss or you leaving the arena not feeling good about what you were able to do that day. Right? So think about what you felt last year when you left the arena. You had your bag slung over your shoulder, you had your hoodie on, your parents were walking beside you, they were going to take you out to dinner, and you weren't feeling good about what you did that evening. You're like, damn, man, I could be on that podium. I could be one of those guys. I have it in me. I can be one of these guys. I'm better than that dude. Nothing's worse than seeing guys that you think you're better than stand higher on the podium than you are. Right? I think all of us in here want to do something great. For some of us, that might be becoming a state champion. Other of us, we might have the ability to just make it into the varsity lineup, have a 500 record, varies for every one of you guys as an individual, but I know every one of you have goals. And so those goals start today, and we have to push them consistently throughout the remainder of the season. Because anyone can be great on a singular day. The reason that I get the respect that I get in this wrestling community is because I've been able to do this for a sustained period of time. And it's difficult. Simple. People ask me all the time, man, how do you stay motivated? Like, do you ever want to quit? Do you ever feel like not practicing? I'm like, pretty much every day. Every day. It's hard. Right? This journey is difficult. To achieve your goals and live a life of excellence and be great is very, very difficult. But the cool thing about it is that what makes us great, because this sport, there's no promises in this sport. Like, I watch ESPN every day. I see guys are like, in the NBA, max contracts. In the NFL, these guys are getting guaranteed contracts. And I'm like, man, I wish I had a guarantee. Right? I wish I knew whether I won or didn't win, however I performed, I would get paid still. That would be pretty cool. Right? But the great thing about wrestlers is it takes a lot of courage to do what we do. Because could you imagine if you had to only be a Super Bowl champion or NBA champion, World Series champion to get paid? I bet baseball, basketball, football wouldn't be as big as it is now. Right? Because guys would have to work a little bit harder. They'd have to sacrifice a little bit more. And so the courage that you guys have here in a sport where we're considered misfits, right? We don't get a lot of recognition. Remember, I was there those days. Right? The basketball team, the football team, everyone loved them. We could be state champs. People were like, oh, cool, state champs. Football team make it to the playoffs. Everyone freaking go nuts and lose their minds. I'm like, what the? I was a state champ. They just made it to the playoffs. They were 6-4. And the game sold out. Right? It's crazy like that. But the great thing about it is this is the journey that we choose. It's not for the honor. It's not for the recognition. It's not for the financial gain. It's just about the feeling of living your life in an excellent way and doing everything that you're capable of. All right? So this is what we're going to do. I'm going to have everyone on their feet. I got pushed out of bounds with 1 second left on the clock, right? 1 second really came between me and being a world champion again this year. And so if you think about those small margins of error, you understand that in order for you to be great at this sport, you've got to discipline yourself. It's not always about your opponent. Sure, he's good. He's capable of doing cool stuff. He's got great moves, good defense. But if you can master yourself, self-mastery, you can become great at this sport. So what we're going to work on right now is disciplining ourselves in our stance, our motion, taking quality shots, level changing properly, disciplining ourselves, and then also working on our defense. So that means down blocks left and right, sprawling and circling up, and making sure our feet are always moving. When your feet are moving, you become a moving target. That's more difficult to hit. And that makes you a dangerous man. Keeping guys off balance. The more my opponent thinks I'm coming, even if I have no plans of shooting, the more difficult and stressful it is for that guy. You start to see guys wear down late, get tired in the first period. So wrestling differs at every level, but the one thing that you always have to understand is that if you're in good shape and you wrestle hard, you always put yourself in a position to win. That's it. Even if you don't know any moves, if you're in good shape and you wrestle hard, you're going to put yourself in a position to win. All right, so that's what we're going to do right now. So everyone spread out, get some space.